Here's the truth, right? What's happening with all of this, you sound like you are slowly starting to be swayed and think that Connor has a chance.
No, listen. He's got a...
Wolf tickets.
I know somebody
that's
in the Mayweather training camp. Okay, an MMA, I shouldn't say this, I'm giving clues, you could probably work it out. I do this all the time, don't I? But I know somebody in the Mayweather training camp that is saying that Mayweather isn't training very hard. Ooh. He said that Mayweather generally, when he's seen him train, is a thing of beauty, it's a thing of inspiration, that you've never seen a human being work so hard in his life. But he said that on this occasion, he's not working that hard. He's training a bit, but he's not training like he usually does. Now, at the open workout, we saw Floyd Mayweather for around 2 hours just go from bag to bag to bag, throwing an absolutely unbelievable amount of punches. It's crazy that a human being could throw that many punches and not be tired. So I kind of thought, well, maybe he is training. But this guy that I know says that he's not training like he used to. So that obviously sways towards Conor. If Mayweather's taking him lightly, that's going to be a big mistake for him. But still, you know, I would give McGregor a 10% chance of winning this fight.
Yeah, I mean, I guess. Look, puncher's chance, whatever. I'm not swayed anymore. I think Conor's going to impress everybody, and he's going to go to a decision with him.
The one thing is this as well, which Mayweather's saying. He did an interview this week or last week, whenever it was, and he was saying he's going to go forward. He's going to go after McGregor. He's going to knock him out. He said that if it goes to a decision, that's a victory for McGregor.
Yeah, I agree.
Did you see that?
Yeah, and I agree with that. I think if he goes to a decision, simple as that, that is embarrassing for Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah, he should be able to knock him out. But listen, look at what's happening. It's the exact same thing as fucking Jose Aldo. Jose Aldo is a counter fighter. He doesn't go forward. McGregor got into his fucking head, and Jose's like, fuck this guy. I'm going to knock him out. Went forward, which he doesn't really do. That's out of his character for the way that he fights. Went forward, super aggressive, got knocked out. Now we see Floyd Mayweather saying, I'm not going to take a backward step. I'm going to go forward. Now, I think that's just Floyd trying to sell the fight. Okay, he's not going to say that I'm going to back up and be defensive. That doesn't sell the fight. But if he is telling the truth, then he might fall into the same trap of Jose Aldo, because Conor has got the power. All right, Malignaggi says it's not oh my God power. He said it's not ridiculous power, but he said the power is there. And if Floyd Mayweather goes forward, listen, is it going to happen? Probably not. But you can see how the parts of the recipe are falling together to where we might have another Jose Aldo situation on our hands.
Yeah, look, God damn it. If that happens, and I'm calling this right now with everything that's
going on. If that happens, I'm going to shoot myself in the face.
If that happens.
Not because I'm a hater, but he's just like, what the fuck? Jesus Christ. And yeah, speaking of McGregor, Mayweather, if you want to get in on the action and make a little bit of money, if you feel you have a good hunch on how the fight's going to go down, then why not put some money on it? Go to betdsi.com. Betdsi.com has been in business for over 20 years. A-plus rated on sportsbook review sites. Easy to use mobile playing interface. BetDSI offers odds on pretty much everything, including all major sports, politics, reality TV, and of course the McGregor Mayweather fight. So go to BetDSI.com, use the promo code ME25, and you'll also get $25 free to wager just for registering. And if you decide to deposit, you will also get a 200% bonus match on your money. So if you put $100 down, you'll actually have $300 to play with. $50, yeah. $150. You see where I'm going with this. So here's the deal.
And also, they should know for the $25, the $25, they don't have to put anything down. They truly get the $25 if they just go and sign up. So it's not like you have to put $100 down to get the $25. $25 just for going in there and using ME25. That's it. You can become a millionaire, technically.
You could become a millionaire, or you could also take that $25, put it on McGregor, who's currently a plus 400 underdog versus Money Mayweather, meaning that free $25, I say free $25, put that on McGregor. If he wins, you turn that into $100. Use the promo code ME25. It will net you $100 in earnings on a McGregor win. How about that? Not bad. We're giving away free money. BetDSI.com. What more do we need to tell you? We're making you laugh. We're making you smile. We're giving you free entertainment. We're giving you free money. So, guys, go to BetDSI.com. Use the promo code ME25 and put some cash down on McGregor. Mayweather, come on. Win some money.
All right, let's get back into the show.
Well, here's this kind of interesting. It's related because Tony Bellew, who I don't even know.
Bellew.
I don't know, dude.
I know. It's a stupid name.
But he called you out, kind of.
Bellew.
He's a boxer, heavyweight boxer from England. And he said something along the lines of, if I'd get into the cage with a puncher in the UFC, Michael Bisping is a guy who is predominantly known as a puncher, and he's a very strong wrestler as well. I think I can get down to 185 pounds if the money was right. I'm a Michael Bisping fan, but if the money was right, the fan stuff goes out the window. So he said he'd be interested in coming to the UFC possibly and even fighting you. Is that something that you would entertain?
Well, first of all, Tony Bellew had a great fight recently against David Haye. And, I thoroughly enjoyed the fight. So, I'll say it with respect. But I don't really want to fight him in the UFC. I don't see that as a challenge. I mean, a guy that stands there and says, I've got pretty good kicks in this and that, blah, 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 blah. You're a boxer. You don't know jack shit about MMA. And just because you took a couple of taekwondo sessions here and there doesn't mean you can do it inside the UFC. I would take him down and tap him out in a heartbeat. It would be fast, simple as that. He's got no takedown defense, and of course he's a boxer, so I'll just take him down and submit him. People will probably sit there and say, hold on, that's not your style, Mike. But believe you me, I know how to do a takedown, and against a boxer, that would be the game plan. For me to fight Tony Bellew, and of course it sounds like now I'm trying to copy Conor McGregor, but he's the one that called me out, remember? He's the one that did an interview with Sky Sports. It's all over the internet today. Well, it's all over my Facebook feed anyway because people keep tagging me. I'd love to fight him in a boxing match. I'd like to challenge myself. Listen, he's a great boxer, and he had a fantastic fight against David Haye, as I said. And, I think I could stand there and go toe-to-toe with that guy and beat him at his own game. Of course, in the UFC, if he wants to do that, we can do that as well. But, I guess I am jumping on the boxing MMA bandwagon, but he was the guy that called me out, and I'm just saying, let me fight GSP, Madison Square Garden, November 4th, and then I'll take on Tony Bellew in a boxing fight if he wants to do that.
Would you take off time from the UFC? Because you would literally be murdered by UFC fans. That you would have to get a...
Could you imagine if I beat GSP and then instead of fighting Robert Whittaker, went and did a boxing match?
Holy shit. Listen to me. I got to be honest with you. I would jump to the other side. I would say, you know what? Michael Bisping deserves to be stripped.
I almost want to do it just to see the reaction of like, Luke Rockhold. Luke Rockhold and Yoel Romero. I almost want to do it. Almost.
Would you... I mean, you're obviously not like serious about that. Would you entertain that after retirement, though? Would that be something you would want to do?
Once I've retired from the UFC, which, as I say, isn't a million miles away. I mean, who knows? There might always be one more fight. As I said, GSP, then Whittaker, and then who knows? Maybe one more, probably not. But yeah, I would. I'd entertain a big money boxing fight against someone like Tony Bellew. Obviously, it wouldn't be anywhere near the level of a McGregor and Mayweather payday, but it could still generate a lot of business. I mean, Bellew's a good name. It'd sell out Goodison Park, which is a football stadium in Liverpool. So maybe once I'm retired from the UFC, yeah.
I listen to me. I'm telling you right now, fuck Bellew. No offense to him. I'm sure he's great. Fuck boxing. Once you retire, the move is to pull the Ronda Rousey and go to the WWE and be the new British. You will crush it. I'm telling you, because I'm right. You start doing steroids, put like 50 pounds of muscle on you. You come out with a fucking British flag draped over your shoulders. You spit on Cuban flags. You have like, are there any Cuban wrestlers, Shannon? Look it up. See if there's any Cuban pro wrestlers that you could have, Cuban pro wrestlers, Shannon, that you could have a beef with. That'd be incredible.
You know, you paint quite the picture and it sounds very, very good. But... I mean, listen, I'll never say never, but the problem is, those wrestlers, they work their asses off and they're on the road constantly all over the world. But listen, never say never. That's all I'll say to that, Lewis, and I appreciate you trying to line up some business. But I've got a lot of things going on, and if the avenues run dry and I'm not the next Jason Statham, then who knows? I might be the next British Bulldog.
Yeah, the British Bulldog. Is that the last famous British wrestler, I think? Is there any other good ones?
No. Who was the last famous WWE guy?
That was British shit.
British Bulldog, right?
That was like 80s and 90s, though. There was another guy after that came out that was like Lord Steven Regal, I remember.
I have no idea who that is.
Go down, Shannon. Let's see. She's pulling up the top 10. Mason Ryan, never heard of him. Go down. Paul Burchill, don't know. Go down. Layla, don't know. Dave Taylor. None of these fucking... These are the greatest British wrestlers. I've never heard of any of these people. Drew McIntyre.
No, I don't know anything about wrestling. And speaking about wrestling and English wrestling, Callum, my son, obviously, his wrestling career is doing very, very well. He's gotten to the point now, and if he hears this... Again, I hope he doesn't listen to this podcast, because A, I've already rumbled myself...